So the Shaykh rahimahullah is trying to say, فَأَجْعَلُ طَوْعَ بَنَانِكَ رِسَالَةً تَحْمِلُ الصِّفَةَ الْكَاشِفَةَ. I've placed on your fingertip a book that gives you a sifa which describes everything for you. It's clear for you. And you're going to be on clarity. لِحِلْيَتِكَ, so you can adorn yourself. فَهَا أَنَا ذَا أَجْعَلُ سِنَّ الْقَلَمِ عَلَى الْقِرْطَاسِ. And here I am placing my pen, its teeth. What does that mean, my pen's teeth? It shows us that Sheikh's pen was sharpened. Huh?
Pencil.
The pencil that he used. The pencil. Pen, this is a pen, right? The one that you sharpen is a pencil, huh? Yeah. Okay. The Sheikh rahimahullah, so this is balagha. The asalib and the way that the Sheikh is talking is saying, here I am writing. And you don't tend to find that in the books of ilm. Majority of the times balagha is not used. And Sheikh Ahmed, Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, that's why I advise youngsters to try to read his books. Not only him, try to read the books of Ahmed Shakir, Mahmoud Shakir. They're udaba. The Arabic language is very what? And later I'm going to mention some others whose books you need to read, such as the books of Muhammad Bashir al-Ibrahimi. He was an adib. There's a small book written by Sheikh Mahmoud Shakir when I was coming from Egypt. Egypt, when I came back from it on Monday. There was a big book fair in Egypt. 47 countries, they came and they all brought their books. All over the world, there was a big place. Big book fair. So one of the risala I got to buy was a kitab written by Sheikh Mahmoud Shakir. It's called Risalatun ila thaqafatina. A letter which he talks about our inheritance as Muslims, what we have. When you read the balagha and the eloquency that in the speech of these scholars and how they speak and how simple it was for them. Walidhalika Bakr Abu Zayd said himself, I benefited from a handful of people when it came to their books. Ahmed Shakir, Mahmoud Shakir, Muhammad Bashir al-Ibrahimi, and another scholar by Muhammad al-Khudayri, rahimahullah. I benefited from these individuals who wrote books in Arabic. So that is one advice I give you all. Brothers, wallahi, the more you're stronger in the Arabic language, the more you're closest to the religion. And the knowledge, I mean, and the understanding of the religion. And the more you're far from the Arabic language, yeah, the more you're far from being able to learn this religion. Are you with me? You can try to say, for me, that's not my field. I learn other things, you know, I'm good with aqid, or I'm good with fiqh, I'm good with this. But if you're far from the Arabic language, brothers, you've got a big thing missing from you. Give time to the Arabic language. So the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, فَهَا أَنَا ذَا أَجْعَلُ السِّنَّ الْقَلَمِ عَلَى الْقِرْطَاسِ. Here I am placing my pen on my paper. Qirtas means paper. فَتْلُ مَا أَرْقُمُ لَكَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ بِكَ عَيْنًا. The Shaykh saying, I'm reciting that which I'm going to write for you. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give comfort and blessings to your eyes. So the Shaykh rahimahullah is trying to say to you, not only have I written it for you, but as though I've even read it out for you. Shaykh is trying to say, I've put every effort to place this for you. لَقَدْ تَوَارَدَتْ مُجِبَاتُ. It has been affirmed and it has been transmitted in large amount. From what? مُجِبَاتُ الشَّرَعَ. The motives of the sharia. عَلَى أَنَّ التَّحَلِّيَ بِمَحَاسِنِ الْآدَابِ وَمَكَارِبِ الْأَخْلَاقِ وَالْهَدِّي الْحَسَنِ وَالسَّمْتُ الصَّالِحِ سِمَةُ أَهْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The Shaykh said, it has been affirmed, the motives of the Sharia, by adorning yourself with beautiful etiquettes, وَمَكَارِمُ الْأَخْلَاقِ and noble manners, وَالْهَدْيُ الْحَسَنِ and good behavior, وَالسَّمْتُ الصَّالِحِ and pious conduct. And that it's what? سِمَةُ أَهْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ. It is the sign of a Muslim. To have all of those, to have beautiful etiquettes, to have noble manners, to have good behavior, and to also be a pious in your conduct and the way you deal with people. Brothers, that's one thing you can't lose. The way you speak and your akhlaq and your adab and the way you carry yourself. All of that is what a Muslim does not lose. And that he's always got it, he always has it with him. خاصةً specifically if you're a person who's attributing to himself what? Huh? العلم, knowledge. And that's why when I was speaking to the admin of the masjid, that I chose to go through this book. نحن في أمس الحاجة. We are in most need right now. We need more of what? Good etiquettes than many evidences. Isn't that the case, brothers? Wallahi, we need etiquettes more than a lot of knowledge that we can have today. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us etiquettes and manners and character. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. The Shaykh then said, وَأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ وَهُوَ أَثْمَنُ دُرَّةٍ فِي تَاجِ الشَّرْعِ الْمُطَهَّرِ. وَأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ and that knowledge, وَهُوَ أَثْمَنُ, it is the most precious pearl, دُرَّة is pearl, فِي تَاجِ الشَّرْعِ الْمُطَهَّرِ, in the crown of the Sharia. That crown on top of the Sharia is the crown. The best pearl on that crown is what? Knowledge. So the person needs to carry that with what? With what? Etiquette. As he said, لا يصل إليه إلا بالمتحل بأدبه. And one will not gain that precious pearl unless he adorns himself with what? With good etiquette and good manners. المتخلي عن آفاته. And to stay away from evil etiquette. Because remember, brothers, when you don't have good etiquette, you're always going to have the opposite. Huh? If you don't have this, then you're going to have this. ولهذا, and because of that, عناها العلماء بالبحث والتنبه والتنبيه وأفردوها بالتأليف إما على وجه العموم لكافة العلوم. The Sheikh said, ولهذا, and because of that, عناها العلماء, the scholars devoted their time to research and to write books on the matters of etiquette and characteristics and how a student of knowledge should be. وأفردوها بالتأليف. And not only have they written it, but they specified a book from it. Are you with me? They not only have they written it, but they also specified it in books. Like you find just a whole book written on etiquette, akhlaq, and adab. Scholars did that. Na'am. And some of them, what they did was they added it to the middle of their books. Like Imam al-Bukhari. Bukhari has what? Kitab al-Adab. But then look what when he did that, he still didn't leave it like that. He also wrote a whole specific book on adab, adab al-mufrad. Naam? So if this wasn't important, if it wasn't important, then the scholars would not have wasted their time on it. Are you with me? Naam. And wallahi, brothers, the people will not take from you, and they won't, if you, however much knowledgeable that you are. Are you with me? If you have what? Su'ul adab. If you have su'ul adab, ولذلك some of the scholars they said, Ibn Hazm, who was an imam, a scholar, they said some of the things that prevented his knowledge to spread is because he was a bit too tough. Because of his, he had qaswa, he was a bit harsh. That's why they said, if Allah saves you from the pen of Ibn Hazm and the sword of Hajjaj, you're saved. If Allah saves you from those two, huh? Hazm was very tough. To the extent he said, Tirmidhi, who knows him? Who? And Imam Tirmidhi, he said he's majhool, unknown, no one knows him. He's very tough, Ibn Hazm. But he was a scholar. He was what? A scholar. What prevented that? The scholars, they said, because of his what? So what do you think? Who's not as the level of Ibn Hazm, of knowledge, people won't take it from him. However much adillah and evidences that you have, manners is very important. Isn't that the case, brothers? Sometimes a person may hear something from somebody else, but because the way you said it to them, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala knows. Brothers, Allah's knowledge is beyond what you're going to do, Allah knows it. What you're doing, Allah knows it. What you've previously done, Allah knows it, and He also knows what you haven't done. If you were to do it, how you would have done it. That is Allah's knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sah? Allah knows what hasn't happened. How, if it was to happen, how it would have been? Being like that and having that knowledge, Allah taught Nabiullah Musa to go to Fir'aun. And him and his brother, what did he say to them? اِذْهَبَا إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ طَغَى. Go to Fir'aun, he has exceeded his limits. صح? He's exceeded his limits. فقولا له قولا لينا لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. But speak to him in a way what? قولا لينا, in a soft manner. لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. He may come to his senses and he may come to understand. It's amazing because Allah connected him coming back and for him to remember based on the way you speak to him. And Allah knows. Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows Fir'aun will take this. So who is it a lesson for? And that is why my sheikh used to say, whoever you may be talking to is not worse than Fir'aun. And you for surely are not better than Nabiullah Musa. You are not better than Musa. And the person you're talking to and speaking to is not worse than? So manners is always, brothers. The Prophet of Allah, what did Allah say to him? فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Muhammad, if it wasn't for Allah's mercy, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ, you became soft for the companions. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ, and if you were, فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, if you were one who was tough and rough and hard, the Sahabas would have run away from your surroundings. This is the most noble individual. Alayhi salatu. The Sahabas will not spend, they will not come to you, they will run away from you based on what? The bad etiquettes. So Allah is saying, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Muhammad, you are of high character. So Allah mentions to us there the importance of what? Etiquettes and manners. So the Sheikh said, رحمه الله وأفردوها بالتأليف إما على وجه العموم لكافة العلوم أو على وجه الخصوص كآداب حملة القرآن الكريم وآداب المحدث وآداب المفتي وآداب القاضي وآداب المحتسب وهكذا. The Sheikh said that the scholars, they authored when it came to manners, either generally they spoke about manners in general and they wrote a book on that, or what they did is they actually specified what type of manners in what particular place do you need and what knowledge you need. For example, the etiquettes of the one who's carrying the Quran. There's a book on it. Sah? Even though they spoke about etiquette in general, but they specified it in what carrying the Quran, the etiquette that's needed from you. And also, وَأَدَابِ الْمُحَدِّثِ, and the etiquettes of the scholar of hadith. وَأَدَابِ الْمُفْتِي, the etiquettes of the mufti. وَأَدَابِ الْقَاضِي, the etiquettes of the judge. وآداب المحتسب, and the etiquette of the one who is calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر is the محتسب. وهكذا, and the list goes on. والشأن هنا في الآداب العامة لمن يسلك طريق التعلم الشرعي. The Sheikh said, والشأن, the matter is, هنا, here. In my book, on the other hand, my affairs is what? Etiquette which is general. To anyone who is seeking knowledge and he wants to take the path of seeking knowledge, the etiquette that is needed from him. وَقَدْ كَانَ الْعُلَمَاءِ السَّابِقُونَ يُلَقِّنُونَ الطُّلَابَ فِي حِلَقِ الْعِلْمِ آدَابَ الطَّلَبِ. The Shaykh رحمه الله, he said, وَكَانَ, and they were, the scholars previously were, السَّابِقُونَ يُلَقِّنُونَ, they will dictate. For what? الطُّلَابَ, the students, فِي حِلَقِ الْعِلْمِ, in the circles of knowledge, the scholars, they will dictate. آداب الطالب, the etiquettes of a student of knowledge, they were dictated. وأدركت خبر آخر العقد. The Sheikh said, I reached. وأدركت, I reached. خبر آخر العقد. I reached the final highlight of this. I reached, the Sheikh said. في ذلك في بعض حلقات العلم. In some of the circles of knowledge. في مسجد النبوي الشريف. And I, where did I see this? In the Prophet's masjid. إِذْ كَانَ بَعْضُ الْمُدَرِّسِينَ فِيهِ, because some of the teachers in that masjid, Masjid al-Nabawi, they used to what? يُدَرِّسُ طُلَّابَهُ كِتَابَ الزَّرْنُوجِ. They would teach the book of Zarnuji. And Imam Zarnuji's book. And that book, طُبِعَ مِرَارًا, it was published many times. وَهُوَ مَعَ إِفَادَتِهِ, even though there are benefits in it, a lot of benefits, لكن in it is what? مَا يَقْتَضِي التَّنْبِيهُ وَالنَّظَرُ. In it is something that needs to be, some things that need to be alerted and say, look, this is not right. It requires it. And it requires some looking. But that book is amazing, Zarluji's book. Do you know what it talks about? It even talks about what food that the student of knowledge needs to eat. If he gets married, should he get married? Questions that people are, I want to seek knowledge. Shall I get married? Should I seek knowledge first? All these questions that students ask, just take this book and study it. Or this book. He explains, even after you get married, the things that you need to do and what not, he talks about it. He talks about it, rahimahullah. So the Sheikh said, I saw people teaching that book. That book is called Ta'leem al-Mut'allimi Tariqat Ta'allumi. That's the book it is. So the Sheikh said, I reached that book while it was being taught in the Masjid al-Nabawi. I used to see it. But now if you see, it's rare that it's taught. فَعَسَىٰ It is possible. أَنْ يَصِلَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ هَذَا الْحَبْلُ الْوَثِيقَ الْهَادِي لِأَقْوَمِ الطَّرِيقِ فَعَسَىٰ It is possible. أَنْ يَصِلَ That this is extended. The scholars, the people of knowledge, they extend this rope. Which rope? This firm rope which guides to the noblest of ways, which is to teach the students the etiquettes first. I hope that the scholars, they do this. They pass it on. And they extend that rope to the students, the youngsters, making sure that they learn their etiquettes and their manners. وَفِي مَوَادِ الدِّرَاسَاتِ النَّظَامِيَةِ And that they also add to the what? The academic curriculums, issues pertaining to adab, that they add it to it. وَأَرْجُ أَنْ يَكُونَ هَذَا التَّقْيِيدُ فَاتِحَةَ خَيْرٍ فِي التَّنْبِيهِ عَلَىٰ إِحْيَاءِ هَذِهِ الْمَادَةِ الَّتِي تُهَذِّبُ الطَّالِبَ And he said, I also hope that this book of mine is an opening of good in bringing to the people's attentions and reviving this topic and disciplining the students. I hope my book plays a role in that. And it did. No doubt it did. Because he was alive, في قيد الحياة, the Sheikh was alive when Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, are you with me? Was explaining his book. Because Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen died before Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd. Are you with me? And if we have to say Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen was higher in knowledge than Sheikh Bakr. مع ذلك Sheikh Bakr, Sheikh Uthaymeen taught it. Huh? Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen sat and he taught the book of his brother Bakr Abu Zayd. And this is how the ulama were towards one another. The love and the compassion and the rahmah they had for one another. So Allah did give this book acceptance. Al-Qabool, acceptance. Just about every student of knowledge will know about the Kitab Hilyat Talib al-Ilm. وَتَسْلُكُ بِهِ الْجَادَّةُ فِي آدَابِ الطَّلَبِ وَحَمْلِ الْعِلْمِ And this book, it will give the student of knowledge to adhere and to tread on the path of etiquette and how to carry knowledge. Because this is a common question, I want to study, where shall I start from? What shall I do? Shall I memorize or shall I not memorize? I hope after this book there won't be that question. And some say, okay, how should I memorize? Everything, wallahi, you may ask, and even more. The Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, he explains it here. وَأَدَبِي The book also talks about what? The etiquettes, وَأَدَبُ The etiquettes, مَعَ نَفْسِهِ With yourself. The etiquettes that you should have with yourself. وَمَعَ مُدَرِّسِي With your teacher. You see, some people don't have good etiquettes with themselves. And they also don't have etiquettes with their teachers. You see, he learns two books with his teacher, the next day he throws the table at the teacher. And he belittles and ridicules the teacher. You see, وَدَرْسِهِ And also no manners with his own lessons that he takes. And how? When you've spent days of studying this book, why have you thrown the book away for? And how can you benefit? How can you benefit from a book that you're reading? And how to extract benefits from it? And how you, because every book a student of knowledge reads, today you read this book, Hilyatu Talib al-Ilm. The book in the English language is different. In the Arabic language, the content page is at the back. The content page, where is it? It's at the back. The person who did this content page, he did it based on his understanding. It's not revelation. It's not a wahy min Allah. It's not a revelation from Allah. Why don't you rewrite the content page for yourself? So when you want to reference that page, what you've seen from that page, what you've understood from it, might be different from what he's taken from the page. Does that make sense? And so it allows you to have your own content page when you want to reference the book again. Not only that, summarize the book. Summarized the book by taking out what you think that the sheikh done istidrak of. He went off topic. That does not fall under the topic that's there for you. Take it out. Even if it means to do tahdhib of the kitab, to organize it, take words that if you think something that he said there can be put under here, then do it. This is not a, it's not a Quran. It's for, and this is a sign to show that you've understood this book. If you could summarize the book and you could rewrite a content page for it. This is what our Sheikh, Sheikh Abdul Karim Al-Khudayr, this is what he used to say. Anyone who can summarize a book, anyone who can what? Summarize a book and rewrite a content page, verily that person has understood that book. Good. And also his etiquette with his colleagues and those who's with. وَكِتَابِهَا and his book. وَثَمَرَةُ عِلْمِهِ and the fruit of his knowledge. وَهَكَذَا فِي مَرَاحِلِ حَيَاتِهِ and all over his years of seeking knowledge. فَإِلَيْكَ on upon you is حِلْيَةً sorry. فَإِلَيْكَ upon you is what? حِلْيَةً تَحْوِي مَجْمُوعَةُ آدَاب. فَإِلَيْكَ upon you is حِلْيَةً this حِلْيَة طالب العلم. حِلْيَة means to beautify yourself with something, to adorn yourself. It's upon you. تحوي it contains مجموعة آداب a number of etiquette. نواقضها and also its opposites. مجموعة آفات and also evil etiquette. It also mentions it. فإذا فات أدب منها اقترف المفرط آفة من آفاته. And anyone who loses the etiquette that is needed from him, he's always going to come in the opposite that's going to be there. فَمُقِلٌ وَمُسْتَكْثِرٌ When it comes to the etiquette, some people are high, some people are little. When it comes to the evil etiquette, some people have a lot of evil etiquette. And some people, they're little. You see, وَكَمَا أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْآدَابَ دَرَجَاتٌ صَاعِدَةٌ إِلَى السُّنَّةِ فَالْوُجُوبُ فَنَوَاقِذُهَا دَرَكَاتٌ هَابِطَةٌ إِلَى كَرَاهَةِ فَالتَّحْرِيمُ The way that this etiquette is of levels, some of them are sunnah, some of them are wajib. The same way when it comes to that which negates the etiquette, some of them are disliked, they're makruh. They're not haram. It's just like, akhi, why would you do that for? You see? And also, some of them are haram. Are you with me? Some of them are what? Haram. Some things from student knowledge is not good. Good etiquette. Are you with me? Like student knowledge, we eat a burger on the street. Like, it's not haram. You're not going to find ayah and hadith. Like in karaha, it is what? It goes against muru'ah, etiquette, and the way a student of knowledge carries himself. Some things no one can say to you is haram, there's evidence for it, but it is what? Now that you've embarked on this path of seeking knowledge, this is karaha. وَمِنْهَا مَا يَشْمُلُ عُمُومَ الْخَلْقِ مِنْ كُلِّ مُكَلَّفٍ Also some of the etiquettes that I'm going to be mentioning, that it encompasses everybody, without any exceptions, everyone. And from them is, وَمِنْهَا مَا يَخْتَصُّ بِهِ طَالِبَ الْعِلْمِ And some things is specific to a student of knowledge. وَمِنْهَا مَا يُدْرَكُ بِضَرُورَةِ الشَّرْحَرَ And some of the etiquettes that I'm going to be mentioning, some of them are taken directly from the evidences of the Kitab and the Sunnah. And some of them, مَا يُعْرَفُ بِالطَّبْعِ It's not by nature that this is not good. وَيَدُلُّ عَلَى عُمُّ الشَّرَحِ But even then, when nature tells us it, it doesn't mean that there's no evidence for it. There's an overall evidence that it can fall under. You see? مِنَ الْحَمْلِ عَلَى مَحَاسِنِ الْآدَابِ That pushes you to go in for those good etiquettes. وَمَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ وَلَمْ أَعِنِ الْإِسْتِفَاءَ The Sheikh said, and I also did not intend in this book of mine to encompass all the etiquettes that are needed. Not at all. لَكِنَّ سِيَاقَتَهَا تَجْرِي عَلَى سَبِيلِ الضَّرْبِ الْمِثَالِ But the layout, in the way I've put it, it will suffice you and it will be a hint for whatever is other than that. It will hint it towards you. Are you with me? And it can be points that you can look at and say, oh, this one falls under it as well. فَإِذَا وَافَقْتُ نَفْسٌ صَالِحَةً فَإِذَا وَافَقَتْ نَفْسٌ صَالِحَةً لَهَا تَنَاوَلَتْ هَذَا الْقَلِيلَ فَكَثَّرَتْهُ وَهَذَا الْمُجْمَلَ فَفَصَّلَتْهُ وَمَنْ أَخَذَ بِهَا انْتَفَعَ وَنَفَعَ The Sheikh said, and if this book comes into the hands of a righteous individual, and he takes it, He takes this little that I writ and he makes it a lot. And he adds what to it he finds. He points out any other benefits that are in it. And so this book is this small right now. And Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen made it into This much. So he did increase into it when he explained it and went in it. وَهَذَا And also there are things that are in it which are ambiguous, that are clarified. And there are also in it things that are little, but it was made a lot. وَمَنْ أَخَذَ بِهَا إِنْتَفَعَ وَنَفَعَ Anyone who takes this book of his, he will benefit and benefit others as well. وَهِيَ بِدَوْرِهَا مَأْخُوذَةٌ مِنْ أَدَبِ مَنْ بَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِي عِلْمِهِمْ And this book, the etiquettes that are in it, it was taken from the etiquettes of those people Allah has blessed, from the prophets and the righteous people, the companions. وَصَارُوا أَئِمَّةً And because of that they became leaders. يُهْتَدَى بِهِمْ Through them one would find guidance. جَمَعَنَا اللَّهُ May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bring us together. بِهِمْ Us and them فِي جَنَّتِهِ آمِين The Shaykh as Muqaddima will stop there. Just some of the books that the Shaykh relied on, I'm going to quickly mention that he got this book from. He relied on some books to get all of these benefits from. And a student of knowledge should have these books in his library and try to read them after, inshallah, we study this book. The book, I'm going to go over it fast, inshallah ta'ala. You guys can go to the tape and listen to it later. Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, he is Jami'. He has another book called Al-Faqih wal-Mutafaqih. Al-Zarnuji's kitab, Ta'alim al-Muta'allim al-Tariq al-Ta'allumi. Adab al-Talib by Imam Muhammad ibn Ali al-Shawkani. Akhlaq al-Ulama by Imam al-Ajurri. Adab al-Muta'allimin al-Suhnun. رسالة المفضلة مفصلة لأحكام المتعلمين باي للقابسي تذكرة السامع والمتكلمين أو المتكلم سوري لابن الجماعة الحث على طلب العلم للعسكري فضل العلم السلفي على الخلف ابن رجب جامع بيان العلم وفضل باي ابن عبد البر العلم فضله وطلبه لأمين الحاج فضل العلم فضل العلم باي محمد سعيد رسلان مفتاح دار السعادة ابن القيم مفتاح دار السعادة شرح إحياء باي زبيدي جواهر العقدين للسمهوري آداب العلماء والمتعلمين باي حسين بن منصور قانون التأويل ابن عربي روت العزلة باي الخطابي أخلاق من أخلاق العلماء محمد السليمان مناهج العلماء فاروق السمرائي التعليم والإرشاد باي بدر الدين الحلبي الذخيرة للقرافي The first volumes only. The first volume only. Al-Majmu' by Imam al-Nawawi, the Muqaddimah. Tahshid al-Himam fi ila al-Aliyah by Muhammad Ibrahim Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Shaybani. Rasail al-Islah by Muhammad al-Khadir Hussein. Athar Muhammad ibn Bashir al-Ibrahimi. And other than that, the scholars, they use in terms of etiquette. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he used some of them to talk about etiquette. And others, he... The Shaykh Rahimahullah, these are some of the majority of the books I mentioned he took from them, and some of them he hasn't because they were after him. So inshallah ta'ala, next week we're going to go into the book Bi'idhnillahi al-Kareem. Today it might have been a bit complicated and hard because of my weak translation and explanation, and also the Shaykh Rahimahullah ta'ala, he's a bit sophisticated in his wordings. But inshallah ta'ala, once we go into the book, it will make a lot of sense and it will be very simple for us, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. It's a book full of quotes and benefits, inshallah ta'ala. If you can just bring with you the matan, everybody please, bring with you the Hilyat Talib al-Ilm, the book by Bakr Abu Zayd. Just bring it with you, this. Don't bring anything else, because it's important that the student understands the matan. And from this, inshallah ta'ala, you're going to learn the Arabic wordings as well. I'm going to explain each word and you're going to write the Arabic, the English on top of it.